We've been working on our biggest release yet, BuildIT 2015. We have a few major changes that we're excited about. Here's a sneak peek at what you can expect. You've seen the updated designs in Record Cloud and Inspect Targets in our last release, and in this one, we finished the makeover of the Inspect Geometry command. We've overhauled the Inspect Control window. Most importantly, it now has all four measurement actions: Measure, Discard Last, Accept, and Discard All. In addition, you can now easily switch between trigger modes, by button, for stationary points, by distance, or by time. The number of samples required for a stationary point can be set for all commands, in the broker. You'll be given the last point's RMS value and the ability to easily discard it. You'll have noticed that in 2014.5, the probe display button was moved outside of the command so that you can activate it at all times. Following the same trend, we've moved many of the settings and filters either to the command form or into the general settings, making the important options easier to access. We've continued adding large cloud manipulation capabilities that improve reverse engineering applications from scans. In our previous release, we improved our cloud handling tenfold. We import and handle clouds containing a couple hundred million points with staggering speed and efficiency. Now, with the new Create Mesh from Cloud command, you can polygonize your large scans in a matter of seconds. This fresh feature adds new possibilities to BuildIT. By exporting this mesh into an SDL file format, you can use it in your preferred CAD software or send it directly into your 3D printer software for rapid prototyping. Recorded objects will now move automatically along with their associated measurements. This will improve many workflows, including any that relied on drift nests for station moves. And if you don't want your constructions to follow your measurements, simply delete the associations. Alternatively, you can easily create associations through your right-click menu if you select your geometry and measurements. And to make it easier to keep track of what is measured, a small red dot appears on the geometry's icon. As for the design folder, we've added the possibility to have groups and groups while removing the separations by type so that your model imports keep the same tree structure they had in their native CAD software. And to further improve organizing in the manager, we have added the options of sorting alphabetically, chronologically, or by type. We've added the possibility to import a CAD format from another Autodesk product, AutoCAD. Measurements are now listed in the spreadsheet, giving you an overview of each of their properties. We now support a multi-level undo and redo, allowing you to revert a virtually unlimited number of steps. And finally, GD&T workflows are continuously improving at each release. We've added a lot of flexibility to the way a cylinder feature can be inspected. It no longer requires a minimum of 7 points. You can take measurements on a thin slice of the cylinder with 3 to 6 points, and it will evaluate your measurements as a circle. You can also take your measurements on the cylinder axis with 1 or 2 points. And now, the results of the analysis are displayed in the GD&T annotations. Visit our website at builditsoftware.com to download a free trial of BuildIT 2015 and take advantage of the latest enhancements.